So I think this is printed, so it's on.
Oh, what is it?
It's.
Well, let me get the book out.
Exodus 17. I can read from here.
Have you?
Yes.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our service of Evensong here in St Mildred's in Tenterden, and a special welcome to those of you who are watching on our live stream. We begin our service this evening with the hymn Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of Creation.
Open thou our lips,
and our mouths shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with psalms.
For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods.
In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also.
The sea is his, and he made it. And his hands prepared the dry land.
Come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand.
Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness.
When your fathers tempted me, proved me and saw my works. unto whom I swear in my wrath that they should not enter into my rest. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. From the wilderness of Sin, the whole congregation of the Israelites journeyed by stages as the Lord commanded. They camped at Rephidim, but there was no water for the people to drink. The people quarreled with Moses and said, "Give us water to drink." Moses said to them, "Why do you quarrel with me? Why do you test the Lord?" But the people complained. They thirsted there for water and complained against Moses and said, "Why did you bring us out of Egypt to kill us and our children and livestock with thirst?" So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? They are almost ready to stone me." The Lord said to Moses, "Go on ahead of the people and take some of the elders of Israel with you. Take in your hand the staff with which you struck the Nile and go. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock at Horeb. Strike the rock, and water will come out of it so that the people may drink." Moses did so in the sight of the elders of Israel. He called the place Massah and Meribah because the Israelites quarreled and tested the Lord, saying, "Is the Lord among us or not?" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Saviour.
For he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden.
For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed.
For he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name.
And his mercy is on them that fear him throughout all generations.
He hath showed strength with his arm. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts.
He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. He, remembering his mercy, hath holpen his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and his seed for ever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel according to John. Jesus came to a Samaritan city called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired out by his journey, was sitting by the well. It was about noon. A Samaritan woman came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone into the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How is it that you, a Jew, ask a drink of me, a woman of Samaria?" Jews do not share things in common with Samaritans. Jesus answered her, If you knew the gift of God and who it is that is saying to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water. The woman said to him, Sir, you have no bucket, and the well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our ancestor Jacob, who gave us the well, and with his sons and his flocks drank from it? Jesus said to her, Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. Excuse me. But those who drink of the water that I will give them will never be thirsty. The water that I will give will become in them a spring of water gushing up to eternal life. The woman said to him, Sir, give me this water so that I may never be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water. Jesus said to her, Go, call your husband and come back. The woman answered him, I have no husband. Jesus said to her, You are right in saying, I have no husband, for you have had five husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. What you have said is true. The woman said to him, Sir, I see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you say that the place where people must worship is in Jerusalem. Jesus said to her, Woman, believe me, the time is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming and is now here when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father seeks such as these to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. The woman said to him, I know that Messiah is coming, who is called Christ. When he comes, he will proclaim all things to us. Jesus said to her, I am he, the one who is speaking to you. Just then his disciples came. They were astonished that he was speaking with a woman, but no one said, What do you want? Or why are you speaking with her? Then the woman left her water jar and went back to the city. She said to the people, Come and see a man who told me everything I have ever done. He cannot be the Messiah, can he? Many Samaritans from that city believed in him because of the woman's testimony. He told me everything I have ever done. So when the Samaritans came to him, they asked him to stay with them, and he stayed there for 2 days. And many more believed because of his word. They said to the woman, It is no longer because of what you said that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this truly is the Saviour of the world. Here ends the second lesson. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word,
for mine eyes have seen thy salvation,
which thou hast prepared before the face of all people,
to be a light to the light of the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the King.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness.
And make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people.
And bless thy inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord. O God, make clean our hearts within us.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
O Lord, we beseech thee, absolve thy people from their offences, that through thy bountiful goodness we may all be delivered from the hands of those sins which by our frailty we have committed. Grant this, O Heavenly Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our blessed Lord and Saviour, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servant that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Because me, as deep as
In the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please, would you sit? I want to change the world, said Tiny Dragon. Start with the next person who needs your help, replied Big Panda. Big Panda and Tiny Dragon are beloved friends who have the shortest of conversations, but they are very powerful. With any big task, it's very easy to look at the big picture and forget the first tiny steps. Whether it is sorting all the stuff in the loft, completing a degree, walking the length of the country, or bringing about world peace. The place where the task begins is always a small but vital fraction of the finished job. Jesus meets a woman at a well in an encounter that was, in its time, completely countercultural and should probably not have taken place. As a Jewish male, Jesus would have been in a position of advantage over this woman. But he was also a thirsty traveller, which put him somewhat at a disadvantage. Jesus made himself vulnerable by asking the woman for a drink. This gave the woman an upper hand in a scene that then becomes one of paradox. Here is the giver of living water, thirsty himself. A thirsty Messiah and a resourceful woman soon find out the need they have of each other. A beautiful metaphor of how God and humanity are intimately connected. And from this conversation, Jesus begins to change the world, or at least in the part of the world where the lady or the woman lived. First of all, he impacted on the life of the woman and then subsequently the rest of the village. We are told that many Samaritans from that city believed in him because of the woman's testimony. It was a chance conversation that took both people beyond the acceptable boundaries and in which both showed their vulnerabilities. How often do we make ourselves vulnerable for the sake of someone else? That difficult conversation with someone who's just received news of a terminal illness. The recently bereaved, the person we disagreed with last time we spoke. Small beginnings, small steps. But what is the chance that initiating that conversation could change their world, even if it doesn't change the world? Amen. Now let us come before God in a time of prayer. Lord, as we journey towards the promised land, refresh, renew, restore us in thy service. We pray for churches where life has become dull and dry. For churches struggling for survival. We pray for Christians drained of energy and resources. We remember those who thirst for thy presence and saving power. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who thirst after justice, those working hard to improve our world. We remember those suffering from weariness and exhaustion. And we pray for those who live in lands parched by global warming, those who suffer the effects of drought. Good and gracious Lord, give us the water of life. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, Lord, for all those who feel wrung out or dried up, all who are wearied with the journey of life, all who feel they are near to perishing. We pray for those who are unable to cope by themselves, for those who are in care, and for all who are caregivers. Remember before you this evening, Stephen Beasley, Heather Parker, and Lalagi Goff. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for the fellowship of those whose journey is over, those who hunger and thirst no more, all who have been refreshed and restored in thy kingdom. We pray for Tim Senior, Tony Hale, Stuart McCorkadale, Tony Perlman, Peter Sionese, and all who have died recently. And on the anniversary of her death, we remember Rita Payne. May we share with them in the fullness of life, which is eternal. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal God and Father, we thirst for thy love. We long for thy presence. We yearn for thy peace. Come, Lord, restore us, that we may live to thy glory. Through him who gives us the water of life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Join together in the general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We beseech thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Amen. Unto him that loveth us, and loosed us from our sins by his own blood, and hath made us kings and priests unto his God and Father, to him be glory for ever and ever. And the blessing of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen.